बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू डियर स्टूडेंट्स इन नाइन्थ क्लास। वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट मैथमेटिक्स। द फर्स्ट यूनिट ऑफ आवर बुक इज मैट्रिसेस एंड डिटर्मिनेंट्स। वी मस्ट नो दैट मैट्रिसेस एंड डिटर्मिनेंट्स आर यूज्ड इन डिफरेंट फील्ड्स लाइक इन मैथमेटिक्स, इन फिजिक्स, इन स्टेटिस्टिक्स एंड इन सम अदर ब्रांचेस ऑफ साइंस। The matrix also have a very importance in this modern age of computer science. Here the word matrices is a plural form of matrix, and let me tell you that the idea of matrix was given by an English mathematician whose name was Arthur Cayley. He was the first mathematician who developed the theory of matrices. Today we will discuss about matrix, the order of matrix, and about equal matrices. We will discuss these points one by one. First of all, we will define matrix as it is a collection of real numbers that are formatted in the form of rows and columns, and these real numbers are enclosed in brackets. The numbers that are used in brackets are termed as entries or elements of a matrix. We can clear it with an example. As you can see a matrix on your screen, there are 9 elements in this matrix which are arranged in the form of rows and columns. All these real numbers are written within the brackets. So in this way we can form a matrix. Matrices are conventionally denoted by capital letters of English alphabet. Here we will give name A to this matrix like this. So we can call it a matrix A. Now we will discuss rows and columns of a matrix. If we talk about rows, these are the entries that are presented in horizontal form, and on the other hand, if we write the entries in vertical form, then we can call it column. For example, in the matrix A, real numbers are arranged in horizontal form. These are called rows. The first row is named as R1, second row is named as R2. Similarly, third row is named as R3, and in the matrix B, real numbers are organized in vertical form. These are called columns, and these are named as C1, C2 and C3. Here, we will find the order of our matrix. To find the order of any matrix, we must know about the number of rows and columns of that matrix. Like in matrix N, first of all we will find the number of rows and columns. As you can see, here are 3 rows and 3 columns, so we can write the order of matrix N is 3 by 3, because here are 3 rows and 3 columns. And in the second example, you can see here is only 1 row and 3 columns, so we can write the order of matrix P as 1 by 3 because it has only 1 row and 3 columns. The term we will discuss here is equal matrices. Two matrices are said to be equal if they satisfy the two conditions. First condition is that order of both matrices must be same. Order means that number of rows and number of columns in both matrices must be equal. For example, if the order of first matrix is 2 by 3, then the order of second matrix must be 2 by 3. Second condition is that their corresponding entries must be equal. Corresponding entries means that first element of first matrix must be equal to the first element of second matrix. Similarly, second element of first matrix must be equal to the second element of second matrix. If the matrices fulfill these two conditions, then these matrices are called equal matrices. Two matrices A and B are said to be equal if their orders are